Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss some of the sub-topic under the heading. My heading is sexual reproduction in flowering plant, and my sub-topic is structure of pollen grains and ovules, next pollination, and third fertilization. First of all, I like to discuss the structure of pollen grain. As we know that pollen grain is a milk gland and it is produced in anther. Anther is the male reproductive part of flower. Actually, pollen grain is a spherical insect and it has a hard coating. Its coating is made up of two layers. First, outer layer is called egg gland and inner layer is called intyme. Now, there are two cells are present inside the pollen grain. The first cell is called vegetative cell and second cell is called generative cell. Now this vegetative cell produces pollen grain and generative cells takes part in fertilization. Now another structure is ovule. This is ovule and longitudinal section of ovule. Actually, ovule produced inside the ovary. It is attached with the inner wall of the ovary. And it is attached by a stalk-like structure. That stalk-like structure is called follicle. Now, when parameters mass of cells are present, this parameters mass of cells are known as nucellus. Nucellus have a small opening, small pore-like structure. That pore-like structure is called micropyle. So this is a micropyle. Through this micropyle, pollen tube enters into the embryo cell. Now this is the embryo sac present in ovule, and this embryo sac contains 8 cells. 3 cells are present at the chalazal end of the ovule. So this is chalazal is a basal part of the ovule. This is the basal part and this is the front part, and at this end 3 cells are present. These 3 cells are called antipodal cells. In the middle of the embryo sac, 2 cells are present. These 2 cells are called polar cells, and these polar cells fuse together to form a secondary nucleus. Now at the micropylar end, so this is called micropylar end of the nucellus. This part is called nucellus. This is the micropylar end of the nucellus. At the micropylar end of the nucellus, there is an egg cell and 2 synergid cells are present. So this is a structure, internal structure of ovule. Now, second, my subtopic is pollination. Actually, pollination is a process in which pollen grains transfer from anther to a stigma. Once again, pollination is a process in which pollen grains transfer from anther to a stigma. So, this process is known as pollination. This is important phenomena in the sexual reproduction of flowering plant. There are 2 types of pollination. One is self-pollination, other is cross-pollination. In self-pollination, pollen then transfer from anther to a stigma between the 2 flowers of same plant. Between the 2 flowers of same plant. So this is called self-pollination. In cross-pollination, transfer of pollen from anther to a stigma between the 2 flowers of 2 different plants. There is 2 different plants. So this is called cross pollination. Now, agents of pollination, yani kiske dwara pollination hota hai? Pollination ke liye kaun kaun se agent kaam karte hain? So this is called agents of pollination. So first agent is air. Second agent is water. Third agent is insect. तो जिसमें एयर के द्वारा पॉलिनेशन होता है, that is called anemophily. वाटर के द्वारा जो पॉलिनेशन दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रोफिलिक एंड इंसेक्ट के द्वारा जो पॉलिनेशन होता है दैट इज कॉल्ड एंटीमोफिलिक इट मींस एंटीमोफिलिक इट मींस एयर पॉलिनेशन बाय एयर वाटर एंड इंसेक्ट दीस एजेंट्स हेल्प्स इन पॉलिनेशन इट मींस हेल्प इन ट्रांसफर ऑफ एंथर ट्रांसफर ऑफ पोलन फ्रॉम एंथर टू स्टिग्मा Now, my subtopic, third subtopic is fertilization. Fertilization is a process in which male gamete fuses with the female gamete. So, this is called the fertilization. When the male gamete fuses with the female gamete, so this process is known as fertilization. So, actually fusion takes place inside the ovule. Fusion of gamete takes place inside the ovule. When pollen grain falls on the stigma, it germinates. Its vegetative cell, I have already told you, the vegetative cell of the pollen grain produces pollen tube. So this is called pollen tube. Pollen tube penetrates into the ovary and enters into the ovule through micropyle. Through micropyle, it enters into the ovary and embryo sac. When it enters into the embryo sac, pollen tube releases two male gametes. One of the male gamete fuses with the egg cell and other male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus. It means fusion takes place at two places. Fusion takes place at two places. So that's why this type of fertilization is known as double fertilization. Fertilization takes place at two places. So that this type of fertilization is known as double fertilization. One, the male gamete fuses with the egg cell and it forms zygote. So egg cell forms after fusion itself forms zygote and zygote develops into embryo. So this is the post fertilization change. Now this secondary nucleus, this is already deployed after the fusion of male gamete, it becomes triploid and after fertilization it develops into endosperm, primary endosperm nucleus, and this primary endosperm nucleus develops into endosperm. It means after fertilization, this secondary nucleus develops into primary endosperm nucleus and finally it develops into endosperm. So after fertilization, this ovary develops into fruit. Ovary develops into fruit and this ovule develops into seed. So this whole change known as post-fertilization changes. Thank you. Have a nice day.